Hey everyone, in today's video we're tackling the sticky trigger problem on the Xbox One controller. If your LT or RT buttons are sticking and not clicking like they used to, don't worry, we're going to fix that. I'll guide you step by step through the teardown process, explain how these triggers work internally, and show you how to get them back to that smooth, satisfying click. By the end of this video, your controller will feel as good as new. So grab your tools, and let's get started. First, open the battery cover. There's a screw hidden under the label. You'll feel the hole when you touch it. You can either peel off the label or pierce it. Use a T9 screwdriver to remove all the screws. As I disassemble the controller, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated with more tutorials. Your support keeps this channel going. Next, we need to pry apart these two plastic pieces using a prying tool. It's best to use a plastic tool to avoid causing any damage. We sent this flying so high, it's probably a new moon somewhere. Remove these two screws. There are two more screws here. Take those out as well. Now, we can lift the back cover. Let's take a closer look at the triggers and how they work. As you can see, there are no physical wires connecting the triggers to the mainboard. Instead, there's a clever magnetic system. Behind the LT and RT buttons are magnets. Underneath, on the circuit board, there's a Hall effect sensor. When you press a trigger, the magnet moves closer to the sensor, changing the magnetic field. The sensor detects this change and registers the trigger input. We figured out how these triggers work. Now we'll remove the front part and investigate why the triggers are sticking. There is rubber behind the LT and RT on the back cover. As you can see, one of them is separated and the adhesive is remaining. Let's clean it. Don't forget to clean this part too. Now there's no more adhesive, which means there won't be any more sticking. However, if you still want that soft touch like when it was new, you'll need to reattach the rubber using adhesive. If you don't have it, just use a small piece of single-sided foam tape. Apply a small amount of adhesive. Place the rubber on it and allow it to dry. We'll start by reassembling. First, fit the front part back in place, followed by the back cover. Be cautious with the two battery plates. They need to be pulled out of the cover properly. Now, tighten all 5 screws. Finally, place the 2 plastic parts back in. The trigger is no longer sticking and the touch feels smooth again. That's it for today's video. See you in the next one.